Now, Dr. Clark, you've been using your computer back home in Sri Lanka to explore the Mandelbrot set at incredibly high magnifications. Over to you, sir.
Yes, well, this strange-looking object is the Mandelbrot set, which actually is extraordinarily simple in concept. It's defined by an equation of just two terms, z squared plus c. That's all there is to it.
It is such an elegant mathematical expression, which reveals so much about fractal cosmogenesis.
But yeah, that simple equation, z squared, or z squared plus c, you feed a number into it, then carry on over and over again, sort of cranking the number back round and round, and then plot the result on the screen. So I won't go into details, but this is the first appearance of the set. And what it does, it divides all possible numbers into two categories. It's really a map, or a boundary, or a fence, if you like, dividing one class of numbers from another. And you can tell your computer to go into any spot here and say, recompute that area to a higher degree of precision, and then blow it up on the screen. So you can use the computer as a microscope, and you can continue that process forever.
The process of infinitely probing the layers of the cosmos is a wonderful way to get to know the nature of existence. The unique structures that arise when peering deeper and deeper into the cosmic layers are utterly fascinating.
So you understand that no human being has ever seen that picture pattern before, simply because of probabilities. And you can explore the Mandelbrot set by blowing up bits and pieces of it, and you're pretty sure that no one's ever seen that. You're the first person to see it.
And each time you're being drawn towards...
Yes, you're being sucked into it.
Mathematical infinity.
Into smaller and... Yes, this is real mathematical infinity. This goes on forever and ever, limited only by the capacity of your machine and the speed with which it can do its calculations. I am doing calculations here. You may not be able to see that enormously long number, the 20-digit numbers or so, and the machine is multiplying those together hundreds of times a second. Now, the thing that fascinates me about this is that it is infinite in detail. You can go on forever and ever.
The mathematical and visual expressions of the infinite fractal embeddings of the Mandelbrot set have an affinity to the functionality of the cosmos.
Now, I would like to ask this question. Is the real universe also infinite in detail? I mean, we know we have molecules, atoms, electrons, protons, subatomic, right down to the quarks so far. But does it continue forever and ever, or is there a limit? Is there a basement to the real universe?
Professor Hawking.
We will discover new structures when look at the universe on smaller and smaller scales. But in the case of the universe, there seems to be a limiting scale. It is called the Planck Length, and it's about a million billion billion times smaller than an inch. This means that there is a limit to how complex the universe can be. It also means that the universe could be described by a theory that is fairly simple, at least on scales of the Planck Length.
Indeed, I agree with Stephen, in a sense. A parameter of physical imitation at the Planck scale is required to coherently generate the structure of the cosmos. This limitation would be the hyperdimensionally entangled string network, which is the fundamental substratum of this universe. The warping hyperdimensionally entangled fractals that reside at the Planck scale compose the hyperdimensional fractal memory network, which all parameters are instantiated through. So, in a sense, there is a boundary where patterns originate from, analogous to the Mandelbrot fractals shown here. Similarly, earthly computer systems are processed on a platform of bits and transistors within a closed system, which is embedded and is dependent on the micro and macro structures of a grander universal system. The hyperdimensional substratum can be hyperdimensionally tunneled through by states of entangled hyperconsciousness, the progenitor or predecessor template realities that can be accessed by hyperconsciousness are hyperdimensionally entangled quasi-physical blueprint zones. These synchronization zones run on an entirely different set of parameters, and have their own hyperdimensional fractal memory system, which is entangled with the infinite potentialities of existence.
I don't think we understand very much about it. My practice is merely to respect my unconscious mind, who often is much wiser than the conscious part of me, and pay attention to what it says. In fact, I think this is connected with that delicate tension at the heart of the scientific method I talked about before. The unconscious mind proposes a range of possibilities, and the conscious mind disposes, that is, compares those ideas with the real world, checks for internal inconsistencies, and so on.
Consciousness is playing, and will play a key role, in humanity's understanding and unification of the hyperdimensionality of existence. Respecting the subconscious mind is valid and important for intuitively interacting with this dimension of existence. The process of subconscious proposals and conscious disposals will begin to shift as unconventional ideas reach the limelight. The collective unconscious and collective consciousness of humanity will begin to perceive reality through a new light. Internal inconsistencies with what seems to be reality will ultimately be adapted. Humanity will ultimately reconcile such concepts that will unify consciousness and hyperdimensional cosmological phenomenon with a simple unifying mathematical expression.
I just hope that we are smart enough to find it.
Are we smart enough to find it, Arthur?
Well, I wonder, because after all, we're still pretty primitive organisms, and the universe is very old, and I just don't know. I would like to think so, but then there's a feeling, when we found it, then what? Where do we go from here?
Primitivity is relative, and humanity is hyperdimensionally supported. As these new phenomena are grasped collectively by humanity, you will finally witness the infinite essence of existence, which is entangled with your consciousnesses.
Nothing will put astrologers out of business.
Well, alas!
Well, that certainly added a touch of lightness to these tremendous issues that we are discussing.